Every year, the policing board produces a human rights report, and it's about three things. First of all, it's about reporting on how well the cops have done in terms of complying with what's known legally as their Article 2 obligations. In other words, have they policed this region from a human rights perspective? Have they protected the rights of vulnerable people? And when they've had to arrest people, have they treated them properly? The second thing we're able to do in the human rights report is report on how certain vulnerable groups have found the year. And, you know, we're talking about people who come from groups who are often the subject of discrimination in our society or unfortunately get attacked. Groups like the LGBT community or the traveller community. Young people who maybe find themselves victims of punishment beatings and summary justice within certain working class communities. And finally, the Human Rights Report is an opportunity for us to be able to raise some significant issues we believe are out there at a policy level. And this year, we will be continuing to express considerable concern about several things. We'll be continuing to worry about how young people are policed and the fact that whilst the PSNI has made considerable progress over the past decade in terms of building its relationship with young people, it is still the worst relationship amongst all people. In other words, young people are the group of people who feel least inclined to support the PSNI and seem to have the worst relationship with them. That is something we need to continue to address, and it's something that in the Human Rights Report this year is highlighted. One of the things we're saying is that, you know, we need to understand that there are some communities who are still looking to paramilitaries for speedy justice, and they're going there for a quick fix. But it isn't, in fact, a fix at all. A punishment attack is not just an abuse of the human rights of the individual who's been attacked, because there's always the possibility that this person is totally innocent. It's also an abuse on the authority of the state. It basically says that we don't believe that the state will be able to deliver justice for us as a community, and we're going to go to someone else. That is a really, really bad place to be. And we're making very specific recommendations in the report to get the police to act in a way where we see punishment attacks going down and we see reports to the police in those communities where they take place going up.
So would you be looking to improve on the clearance rate then of the punishment attacks?
We need to see much better clearance rate. There is an awful clearance rate. We need to see punishment attacks reported. An awful lot of people who get beat up by paramilitaries don't report the fact that they've been attacked, even though they know they are the victim of a punishment attack. And then finally, I think a lot of us would like to see what are known as statutory time limits brought in order to speed up justice, to make sure that young people who are suspected of having committed a crime are processed much more quickly through the criminal justice system. If we do that, we can prove to the communities that whenever a crime occurs and there are suspects for that crime, that they will be dealt with quickly. Well, one of the things about policing is that it isn't been cut like most other services. So really, there is no excuse to say that we don't have enough money to police this place properly. There's more than enough money to police this place properly. The question is, do the PSNI want to spend it in communities or would they rather spend it on security? If you want to make your relationship better with young people, my advice would spend it in communities. Be on the ground, have positive relationships with young people, and guess what? They may actually have a better relationship with you. Young people in general, but particularly young people either in marginalised communities or young people who are maybe vulnerable for other reasons because they're from a different ethnic group or have a different sexual orientation. And we're going to continue to demand that the police treat young people as citizens, as equal citizens, and understand that they have to take the time out to be able to relate to young people through neighbourhood policing and not to always look at them as suspects.